The Magic Historian.
My bones hurt.
Greetings, owners of fine luxury cardboard rectangles. My friends, I hope the day finds you well. We have gathered to discuss Wizards of the Coast's newest marketing strategy. And I have to say, it's absolutely crazy. They are literally reaching out to creators who are completely clowns and sending them packages in the mail. That's right, I'm the clown. This is from Wizards of the Coast and the Artist Collective Mischief. So why don't we take a look and see what's inside? Man, I can't believe I got sent something by an art collective. This is really, really neat. I wonder what's inside this package. Let's get it open and find out what's in here. All right, what do we got here? What do we got? Oh, what? Secret Lair Drop Series Mischief Edition. Oh, nice. Wow, they really have changed Secret Lairs. Look at how much smaller the box is. That's awesome. Ooh, so thin and slick. And wait a minute. What? There's nothing in here.
Now, why would I be sent an empty Secret Lair? What kind of troll is this?
Hey!
What?
We are the Art Collective Mischief. We demand to see your artistic skills. Each successful demonstration means we will give you one of the missing Secret Lair cards.
Oh, things are getting serious. You want to test my art skills? All right, let's do this. There you go. How you like me now, super art intense boy?
That art is garbage.
Not good enough. All right, hold on. This is gonna blow your socks off. Ta-da! The pleasure goat. Show me my card.
Incredible! We bestow upon you Swords to Plowshares.
Swords to Plowshares is a fantastic choice for the first card we're going to look at from this secret lair, because Swords to Plowshares was in the very first Magic set ever made. Now, this artwork is obviously a far cry from the original Swords to Plowshares artwork, and there is a lot going on this card, so let's break it down. This is Swords to Plowshares. You can see they've used a number 2 to make it fancy and cutting edge for the kids. One thing I actually really love about this artwork is the way the casting cost is incorporated into it, because it costs 1 white, and you can see the white mana symbol there, but it's actually also the pommel stone of this sword. And the sword says on it, "We shall melt them in fire." Pretty intense. You've got 3 swords, 1 larger one heading downwards, 2 heading upwards into this forked lightning-filled sky. You've got the little bullets down here on either side that are meant to reference the actual secret lair. You can see Mischief's name slapped on either side and their triple exclamation mark here. And as for what the card actually does, it's 1 white for an instant, exile target creature, its controller gains life equal to its power. A very potent card illustrated in a very interesting way.
Delight us with more art!
More art? Coming right up!
What was that supposed to be?
What do you mean, what was that? Can't you tell an artistic condemnation of corporate culture when you see one? It's very clear. I thought you were an art collective. Now give me my card.
Do not try to out-hipster us. Take this cut to ribbons.
All right, this time we've got cut to ribbons. Again, there's a lot going on this card. This one is a reference to the Satan drop shoes that they made. All right, so starting out at the top, we've got cut. You've got an individual who's sitting down here in black robes. There are 6 swords arrayed around this kind of sun that is behind them. You've got a very interesting stylized border going on. And this actual part of the card that is the spell itself, 1 red and 1 for a sorcery. Cut deals 4 damage to target creature. And actually, you should take a look at the crazy shiny foiling on this one is 2. You see that? That's pretty intense. And then we've got the side of it, which is the second half, the aftermath half, which is ribbons. And ribbons is a sorcery that costs 2 black and X, and it is aftermath. Each opponent loses X life. So essentially how the card works is you have to play the first half to be able to play the second half. And the artwork is an interesting contrast to the other side here, because on this side we've got black robes, on this side we've got white robes, and on this side we've got the swords actually being driven into this individual. Pretty intense. It's almost like a before and after moment where it's like, oh, these swords got jammed into my head. Guess I'll take my clothes off and go for a walk. Not too shabby, very interesting.
Good job! More art now!
Subscribe, like, comment, join my Twitter, join my Instagram, join my Discord, join my channel membership, join my Patreon!
What is all this nonsense?
Come on, man, clearly that's the art of shameless self-promotion. Now let me see my card.
Approved! Witness the Grim Tutor.
This Grim Tutor is one of the wildest magic cards I have ever seen. This one references Mischief's drop called Death of the Influencer. And I have to say, not a huge fan of that name, considering what I do for a living. Now, let's dive into the card. You've got the name Grim Tutor stretched across the top here. You've got what looks like a carving on an old school building here. And then you've got the casting cost located up here with the colorless settled above the two skulls. You got the Mischief name right down there. You got Daddy Dead Boy here with his little hourglass and his manifesto tablet. You got pillars on the side. And as for what the card does itself, it's 2 black and 1. Search your library for a card. Put that card into your hand. Then shuffle. You lose 3 life. Not too shabby. A pretty wild piece of artwork overall. And it gives me like the Day of the Dead kind of vibes. This right here is most assuredly the wildest looking card from this secret lair.
Excellent. Give us more delicious art.
Oh, you'd like some new artwork that's delicious. Very well.
Unacceptable!
What do you hipsters want from me, okay? That's art! Now show me my card!
Very well! We do have more overpriced art to make, so let's move this along. Have a Teferi's puzzle box.
This Teferi's puzzle box actually looks like something from like a PlayStation 2 or 3 game. You must find the loot box drop, which actually kind of does fit pretty well with Magic the Gathering, let's be real. So Teferi's puzzle box is an interesting card to begin with, right? It's a 4 casting cost artifact that says at the beginning of each player's draw step, that player puts the cards in their hand on the bottom of the library in any order, then draws that many cards. I do like the fact that you've got all this text over here, and then on this side you've got the artifact and then the triple exclamation. You got these caution bars running along either side, and then you have the box that says sealed and secured, just like my secret lair was supposed to be. I should have just been able to enjoy the cards and not have to put up with this nonsense. But what are you gonna do? This is what the Mischief Artist Collective wants to do to me, and I am stuck at their mercy because I must have these magical rectangles. This is actually really, really cool and weird at the same time. It definitely feels far, far away from being a Magic the Gathering card. If you showed somebody that, they'd be like, that is not a Magic card. That's from some like futuristic sort of game, right? That's the vibe that it gives off. But it is definitely really cool.
More art now.
Prepare yourselves to be arted.
What even is that?
It's called being a quick change artist. Watch, I'll do it again. Ta-da! That's 2 changes in 2 seconds. Give me my card.
Whatever. Here's a Blood Moon.
Ooh, here we have the Big Daddy card from the secret lair. This is an absolutely nutty looking Blood Moon. There is, again, so much going on this card, right? You've got these crazy concentric rings that are around, what is this 2 different moons? Or is this supposed to be Earth and the moon? I don't know. Maybe it's 2 different moons, but you got 2 different moons flowing around in a circle. You've got the name of the card up here, and then triple exclamation mark, 124.08 below it, and then above it, you've got like a dollar sign and the letters BM, like Blood Moon, right? Casting cost is located over here, one red and two, and then the text, enchantment, non-basic lands or mountains. So this is a pretty desirable card, but there's even more crazy details. Take a look down here. You can see like a graph flowing along, and there's a quotation down at the bottom as well that says some crazy stuff, where it says, the same astrological influences that govern individuals apply to companies, which are, after all, composed of people and legally considered person-like entities. What a absolutely bizarre card, the card that they've created here. And if I'm not mistaken, this is based off of their Bull and Moon drop, all right? And actually, I just realized I didn't mention on the Teferi one that the Teferi was based on their Mischief box.
Final art time! Thank God!
And for my final art piece,
doing nothing is not art!
That one was a twofer. You got the art of stillness and the art of laziness wrapped into one. So, bestow upon me the final card!
Genius! You have revolutionized art and taught us to love again. Have a planes!
And here we have it. The most absolutely ridiculous basic land ever made for Magic the Gathering. It's so wonky and weird, right? This one is based off of their drop that is called, what was it called again? Sorry, one second. Golf Sucks Trophy. That's what they called that one. So in the artwork, you can see there's a real world Earth golf course, and they've got a white mana symbol in the middle here. So they only did the planes, and then it's viewed through this crazy like bolt hole window. It kind of feels like a, like, I don't know, like an old school bus or something. Like you're trapped, maybe you're trapped inside some kind of old timey bolted metal device, looking out the window going, I want to do some golfing. I mean, how much is there to say about this? It's absolutely absurd. And that actually kind of makes it really amazing. So this is the bonus card from the secret lair, which is why it was left till the end. You can see it says down here, basic land plains. And then you have these little like blue flowers around it and whatever. I don't know. It's pretty wild. That's the final card from this secret lair.
Incredible!
Thanks! Now get out of my home!
Wait, what?
No!
Oh god, I got whipped cream everywhere! No!